很难吃的。You happy man, a blind man.Had she met a young lady from Germany, or from Italy, or from China? Had she met your policy? Policy of the wise man. He is told in the Christmas story of the three wise men. Is it carrying gold, frankincense, and myrrh? But they were carrying it.They were not going to get it. Jollity is her name. But have you met that other blind man? The one who did not carry particular wisdom, who did not carry any frankincense or myrrh, and gold was not the nature of his.Wealth. But this man was blind. This man was the blind, leading the blind. Is this wisdom or failure? But if you look at it from the perspective of the blind being led, his policy was statutory. It was laid down. Then you see a policy which is expected will be followed. But they are blind. These people are blind to the nature of ethics because they do not study ethics. They study only words. They study the word written by the common barrister. The word written by the common thief. The word written as the policy. Oh, have you seen our policy? Have you seen our policy? Sire, you know that I am blind. What praises be for that effort you put in to your slavery that made joy and made laughter and made love from that policy. But you know that I am blind, and I know only by the laughter and the sound of those that you have done, that I cannot know your policy as much as I can know your heart. This may be the last piano that you will ever see, because one day you may be blind. One day you may have others tell you what is the policy of a monarch who imprisons an artist, who one day they will throw away the key. Did you ever read the novel? Did you ever read it? Count of Monte Cristo. Which is the story of why I hardly bother to tell it to you, because it's almost laying down a policy. Which is so glued, so entrenched in the arteries of of the bureaucrat, that the policy leads to the mistake that does not assess the crime with the adequacy of punishment. The policy that doesn't accept that it has anything to do with the need to assess before it states its statutory rules to be followed what the punishment will be. But the punishment is the rule, which is unchangeable. The punishment is the place where the monarch has already gone, or the wealthy man, or the carrier of gold. That the Count of Monte Cristo was written by Alex Dumas, and it was assumed to be possibly a collaboration in 1844. And it started in some 100 plus days before Napoleon was released, when he was released from exile, and tells the story of a man who is tricked by this policy. Told one thing when others are meaning that he does another, and they trick him with their policy, and this man is put into a prison van. And it deals with these 15 years up to 1830, and this man vows one day that if there is in the law of righteousness any wisdom or any reconciliation, that wrongs will be put right, he may one day escape from this prison. Which indeed he does. One day escapes by the sea. He becomes wealthy because he finds treasure, gold. And that sweetness is such melancholy because he can only remember his anger. He can only remember what hate he has to address to the man who stole and married his wife and told her that he had been executed when he had not. So when you write the policy, you will remember the bureaucrat who probably wrote it was not concerned with the punishment that is laid out by justice, but whether it is fair or not fair. And you will have the version from the legit as to whether their policy is right. And you will have the version from the court judge explaining to the plaintiff why their persecution of the defendant is perhaps not, or was perhaps not, so wise. I am playing for you a version of something which was written many years ago, a version which was laid down in the rule I'm playing for you a song which was sung by a lady which your ancestors all knew to be from the heart. But that from the heart is not the legit. It is not the legitimate in the rendition which I placed before you. It is not the Sally which Gracie Field sang. It is not the policy which the bureaucrats wrote down. That the Sally that she sang about may have been in appearance to have been the approximate notes to you musicians out there who know notes very well, who know what are the notes and what are not the notes. But this singer was from Rochdale in Lancashire, and her name made the song Sally a national treasure. It made it a national treasure because she was not concerned with the bureaucrats who made wives widows. She was not concerned with the ethics that annihilated generations. She was concerned to tell you that despite your failure, there is one love. Thank you. that you can either accept or you can expel. But this expatriate is from that prison. I have known that prison, what it is to look after and give the food daily or weekly, as the case may be, to set it before this plate of a blind man. A man who is blind to wisdom of the written word, because he cannot see it. And the food of love. What desires thou for your legit, your written word? The room to follow the written word, the policy, with all its tribulation, which it gives so many of you cats out there, those cats who are on a different side to the average slave who is employed by the corporation? Or do you want to have your country singing of your love, Sally? Because I met Gracie Field. I heard her sing, Sally. I, as a film director, took back her message to the man who did not know it then, but he was becoming blind. And the man that I took the message to could not play the piano anymore because he could not see the keys. And that man was Ralph Weeder, commander of the British Empire. A spy. Yes, he was a spy. But he produced Peter Sellers, Dick Emery, Cardew, Robinson, and countless people. Thank you. Leading the blind. Is this wisdom? Is this wisdom or failure?